Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Today, I'm gonna show you guys what all this pipe is laying on the ground at my shore, my gravity feed water system. So this right here is the key to the whole operation. This is Milwaukee's 18 volt transfer pump. I'll put the specs up on the screen so you guys can see how far or high, I guess, this pump can push and how far it can lift. It's amazing. I got quite a height differential between where I pick up the water and the height of the top of the tank that I hold the water in, the water tower. This is a gear drive pump. You can see the rubber wheel inside there. That gives it its power. I was lucky enough to be able to pick up a 9 amp hour battery from Milwaukee. This battery will last for a long time. It's really easy to set this pump up. It's got an arrow on the front of it there, so you know your intake side and your outtake side. And it already comes with hose boob adapters on it. I had to buy the female side, for my 3/4 PEX sprinkler hose that I bought. So all you do is just thread them on and snug them up. One of the benefits of having a gear drive pump is that they're self-priming. I've got probably 12 feet of lift from where the intake foot valve is up to this level here. So I'll be honest, when I'm first setting this pump up at the beginning of the year before the intake line is full of water, I don't let the pump draw the water all the way up here. Actually, this pump has a overcurrent or heat detection in it. So when I've tried to do it without putting a little bit of water in the pipe, it's shut itself off. Now I'm assuming that it's protecting itself. So what I'll do is I'll get a funnel and I'll dump some water down the line until it fills up as much as it can before it gets vapor trapped or vapor locked. And then at least that way there's some water in here which lubricates the inside of the chamber so the gear drive can move. Highly recommend this pump for anybody who's going to do this kind of setup. I think it's sold mostly for plumbers to be able to transfer water out of a hot water tank when they're doing hot water tank changes. That way they can hook the pump up to the hot water tank and quickly exit the water so they can continue with the installation. But it works awesome for this purpose. So here's my high-tech pickup system. I got a milk crate, put some rocks in it, put the pipe through the handle here, a couple tie wraps, hold it in place. It's got a foot valve, so the water can go in, but it can't go out, and a screen. It's not a fine screen, it's a fairly large hole. They're probably 1/8 holes, just to stop some of the bigger stuff from getting in there. And yeah, a worm drive pump is obviously not a garbage pump. Any kind of material that'll get in there can screw up your gear. Gear is just rubber, so I do have a spare gear in case something happens. And in the summertime, obviously. I walk out in the water and put this where I want it. But on shoulder seasons, when the water is 3 degrees like it is now, there's a pretty easy method. Epic fail.
When I first started this operation, I had the barrels you can see in the background up there. But then I was able to get this tote for 90 bucks, 1,000 liters. Built this frame, probably cost me 60 bucks before the price of lumber went retarded. It's a really good setup, I'm very happy with it. The bottom of the tank is probably 3/4 of the way up the height of my trailer. So more than enough gravity to be able to pull the water or push the water down and up and into my holding tank. And then the water pump in the trailer does the rest for the water system in the trailer. I got another shutoff valve here, which I'll explain later. There's a total of 3 shutoff valves. And then I got a union here so that in the winter time, I can disconnect it, take that off. I dump a little antifreeze down the line here. Not a lot, just, I don't know, maybe 1/2 gallon. Just to put a little bit of antifreeze in with the water in case there's some that gets in there after I blow it out. If it does freeze in a low spot or something, it's not going to cause the pipe to burst because it's only a sprinkler system pipe, so it's soft. I got a T here, which comes down to a water valve, so eventually I'm going to set up the sink here and hook it up as well, so that I haven't decided if I'm going to put the sink here or if I'm going to put it over by the washroom. If I put it over by the washroom, I got to run a line underneath the driveway. Bit of work, but worth it to be able to wash your hands. I'm high enough here that I'd be above the height of the sink, so you'd have enough water pressure. For every 28 inches of height that you have water, you gain 1 PSI. So, I don't know, I'm probably roughly 4 feet above the height of the sink when if I put it over there. So that'll give you 24 inches is 4 inches less. So if I'm 4 feet, that's 48 inches. So I'm looking at like roughly 2 PSI I'd have, which is more than enough to be able to wash your hands. You just need a trickle of water to get wet and rinse, right? You can see here from this tap right here, which eventually I'll hook a hose onto. I can wash my car. I'm going to have gardens. I'm going to be able to warm them. That's pretty good. And here again, it's about 5 feet, maybe 6. So pretty happy with the system.
3 water valves in the system. 1 at the pump, 1 at the trailer, 1 here. There's a T in the line. The water comes up, goes from the T to the trailer and then up to this tank. I decide first what I'm going to do. Most of the time I don't start my pump unless my trailer tank is empty. So trailer tank's empty, I'll go to the trailer, I'll open the valve at the trailer, go down to the pump, open the valve at the pump, and this one is closed. Turn the pump on, pump fills the trailer. Then if I need water in here, because that battery I have lasts probably 20 minutes, it's awesome. I'll come over here, I'll open this valve with the trailer valve open, and then I'll close the trailer valve, and then the flow of water can come up here. I open this one first so that it's not deadheading. And then it'll fill up the tank. You can see the amount of water that's in the tank right now. That pump battery pumped and filled my trailer all the way full, including the 6 gallons in the hot water tank. And then it filled that much water into this tank. And like I said, that's a 1,000 liter tote. So it's about 1/3 full. 333 liters is a lot of water. 20 minutes on a battery is a lot of time. So it's a pretty good system. Give my video a thumbs up, like and subscribe. Appreciate you watching. Have an awesome week.